Hey everybody, it's chuggaaconroy. Welcome back to more Legend of Zelda the Wind Waker. In the last episode, we had an epic cliffhanger thanks to the YouTube time limit. In this episode, we're just going to jump right back into things. Here we go. I love the King of Red Lions went that far with no sail just instantly, even though he had to travel like 2 squares on the map to get here. This tower, which the pearls of the gods have caused to appear, is a palace the gods of the ancient world prepared so that they might test the courage of men. What about women? Was able to overcome the trials awaited here. Acknowledge. Okay. Must obtain now. It is before you. Must show your in your own. Must believe in your own courage, which has led you to triumph over many hardships you have faced. You must triumph once again. We must rise above the trial of the gods. All right. Now that that's all done, let's just go ahead and head inside here, and we're going to be starting the 4th dungeon of the game. Let's take it away. Here we are, starting the 4th dungeon of the game. This is the Tower of the Gods. I can't believe it, we're already on the 4th dungeon. Feels like we just started yesterday, but oh well. Let's just go ahead and get into the details for this dungeon. Here we have 3 floors, technically 4, but I'm only actually counting 3 of them though, because only 3 of those floors are before the boss. No spoilers though, but that's just how it is. Not a whole lot of collectibles here. This dungeon is actually shorter than the previous, if you can believe that, despite its size from the outside though. But anyway, let's just go ahead and get it on. Yes, the Tower of the Gods. This place. Like I said, this place, it looks sort of intimidating when you first get in here, though, but it really isn't that bad. This dungeon, despite how it looks from the outside, it's only 3 floors. Technically 4, but that 4th floor is just one room, and there's really... Well, I won't spoil it. But anyway, when you get over here, what you're going to want to do is, you're going to want to go down here first. You don't have to do this room, but doing this room is going to make things a lot easier for you, trust me. And you can see the water actually doesn't drain all the rooms at the same time. Because, well, graphical limitations. Alright, so, excuse me. Whenever you see these electric, chew jellies, you can just go ahead and use your boomerang to hit them. And that'll stun them from using their electricity, I guess. You're going to want to blow this up. There's going to be some other things that you can get from blowing up other things in this room, though, but those really only reward you with joy pennants and rupees. This is the only one that you really are going to want to pick up. But anyway, there is the dungeon map right there. Very, very easy to get. Very surprisingly easy. Not as easy as the forest sanctuary one. The forest sanctuary. It was, like, pathetic how easy it was. Anyway, whoa! Graphical glitch right there. You can see that the water is just a single flat object. Go ahead and around this. And
That's kind of annoying, is waiting for the water to go higher in this dungeon, and then you got, like, that stupid little circle right there that's like, oh my god, you're drowning! Ugh, even though your head is clearly above the water! Sound like Nintendo from Lords Are Not Christmas, but whatever. If anyone's gonna get that reference, put it down. Boom! Just curious what might be in these. Come on, bomb. Okay, back to that bomb, Psalm 99. Go ahead and head in here. And more of these stupid things. Let's go ahead and... Oh! Why does it, like... Why does the water always come up when you don't want it to come up? Why is that? Come on. Wee, look at me, I'm drawing lines in the water. Wee. Okay, picking it up. Putting it down. And then... It's like a stairway to heaven or something. I always like how those things look. I don't know, I thought they look cool. Climb, come on, climb. We don't want the water to come... Aww. I'm gonna wait for the water to come back down. See, that's what I don't like about the first part of this dungeon. You have to wait and wait and wait. Or you can just cut away. Yay, I love using editing. Go ahead and pick this thing up, whatever it is. And it makes it glowy all the time. But go ahead and head through the door. And there's the king of purple panthers over there, whatever you want to call him. Put that down. This is also, I believe, the only dungeon where you actually have the boat with you inside the dungeon, you know, and you actually have to use it, like, to solve things in the dungeon, which I thought was kind of cool. You actually do use some of your boat upgrades, too, in this dungeon, which I thought was kind of a cool idea. It's one of the very few things I actually like about this dungeon, though. I don't like how it's, like, as tall as the frickin' tower from Tales of Symphonia on the outside, and yet it's only, like, 3 floors on the inside, and the 3rd floor is the top. I'm like, okay. Yeah, whatever. It is another ultimate example of more Nintendo logic. Okay, but anyway. Get out, and I command you to rise! Anytime now. There we go. Okay. Moving up. And, oh gee, I wonder what we have to do. There's 2 statues and 2 places where you can put something on the ground. Oh, whatever will I do? There we go. I've had weird times where, like, I put it down in, like, a way, like, where it thinks it's on there, but it isn't. It's weird. But, anyway, go ahead and just jump down here first thing when you get into this room. Go ahead and grab... I said grab... that. Okay, I don't really know if I'll be able to make this, though, but what you're supposed to do is once you've lined up those crates, I was actually supposed to push that other crate forward a little bit more to make them all equal distance from one another, but I don't think it's gonna happen. No, it's not gonna happen. I swear to God, I was just talking to a friend the other day and everything, and she's like, oh my god, this room is so hard, I could never ever figure it out. And then I'm like, oh, don't worry, you just watch the video, I'll show you how to do it really easily. And of course, I screwed up. Alright, now that I pushed it forward, and we cut ahead some more, because I love cheating, yay. We do that, and then, like those, boom. And just because you gave me a little bit of trouble, die. And we get a small key. There really aren't very many keys in this dungeon. I believe this is one of 2. Whatever it is, the little pop-up thing I'll tell you right now. Whoa! More jellies. You gotta be kidding. Whoa, I was like stuck. I got like sandwiched between 2 of them and got stuck. And we're done. That's it for this room. Now back to the hub of the dungeon. Back in the hub of the dungeon, before any of you guys whined at me like, oh my god, why aren't you using the sail? Why are you using the crappy cruise command? Well, there's no wind in here, so you can't sail. It won't do anything. I've tried it. Okay. Now, what I was saying about you using some of your ship upgrades right here is that you gotta blow this thing up with your cannon, because your bombs by themselves won't reach it. And that's pretty much the majority of the usage of the King of Red Lions in this dungeon right there. That's pretty much it, actually. You can't hurt those chew jellies while they're on the water, so if you try to see that boomerang just goes right through them. Wow! I managed to land right exactly on top of him. Wonderful. But you have a key right there, just to get away from the stupid evil jelly! And we gotta kill, like, 4 of them. And okay. Looks like we're just about out of time here, though, so I think we're going to be ending this off right about here, okay, though. So, next time on The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker, we'll find out if I ever manage to kill these three electric jellies. See you guys then. Two jellies, whatever. Stupid official names.